Hola amigos, yo soy Kevin. That's about all I learned. Anyway, today I'm going to respond to one of my customer's question. He bought a sublimation printer from me and have some trouble with a printout. Here I see three different problems. This is the pizza wheel marks. I have another video describe what the pizza wheel marks are and how to avoid them. So I'll just refer you to that video, and I'm going to put a link above and also link in the description. And this printhead strikes, you can see it goes this way. So when the printer prints here, the printhead strike the surface of paper. And another thing you can see is this ink right here. And so this is the end of the paper. So you're going through here, and you can see the paper curves up. So it scraped bottom of the printhead. So you get a lot of ink, get scrape off the bottom of the printhead. And so this is the second problem, is a printhead strike. But what I notice is you print a big white surface here, and there was no printhead strike, but you get a print strike at end of the page. So I'm thinking is that's because your paper curls up. And so my suggestion is use a higher GSM paper. Have a higher coating, so the such as ASAP, and you buy higher weight stock, so that'll be relatively flat. And the third problem is this. Okay, those are, you have too much ink underneath your printhead, so it's dripping down and it's splashing. So every time you print, the ink gonna accumulate on the bottom of printhead a little bit. And if you print a lot of those stocks, you're gonna have more ink concentrated on the bottom. And the printhead cleaning by itself might not be able to remove all those inks, and it may make things worse if you do it too many times. So if you accumulate too much ink, the ink can accumulate and short your printhead and totally destroy your printhead. This is really common for sublimation printers. It's not common on the regular printers because their ink is a little bit thinner, but the sublimation ink got thicker. And you can see those nice juicy dried ink accumulate on the bottom, and they either drip down or eventually they're going to gum up and create a spark, and that's end of your printer and your printhead. And here is one of the spark. You can see the burned printhead and the burned cable. So if you print just one or two small logos, and that's fine, you don't have to do this. However, if you do something like what you're doing, the whole sheet is same color, and you do a lots of them, and you definitely need to maintain it beyond what Epson maintenance program is for. Get a strip from 100% polyester shirt or polyamide shirt. Don't do any cotton shirt. Okay, don't use any shirt that has cotton. If I have a non-woven fabric, that's even better. Anyway, I usually just use a t-shirt. Push the printhead to the right and until it touch the wall. And now you turn the wheel kind of go this way. I guess it's counterclockwise. And now the printhead can be freed. Also, you can just turn on the printer when the printhead moves, cut the power off, but this one is more civilized. So just use the fabric, push it underneath, and you can see it's already cleaned off some of the inks. I clean regularly, so you won't see like as graphic as you see in the other pictures, but you can see it's cleaned it out, and now turn the printer on, it come back to work. I hope this video is helpful. Please visit us at www.bchtechnology.com or locally at Greensboro, North Carolina. Cheers.
BCH, my printer. Save you some cash for that fancy dinner. BCH, my printer. That sweet refill technology.